Okay.
So hi, Christina, and I'm so glad that you could make it today. I know that there's also a special occasion going on.
Yes.
Besides the fact that you have a family birthday today, you had a book birthday yesterday.
That's right. It's in the
Oh.
world. It's
So,
here.
All 13 was published just yesterday, October 13th, 2020, by Candlewick Press. And we're delighted to have Christine. You're going to say your last name for all of us.
Yes, Christina Soontorn-Vaught.
Soontorn-Vaught. Christina Soontorn-Vaught with us to talk about her experiences writing and working in museums and how she came to write this nonfiction book after writing fantasy. So you have a lot of publications to your name, which is wonderful, and I love reading your work. Is this the first time that you've written a nonfiction book?
Yes, it is. So this is my first published nonfiction. But I guess, I've been writing nonfiction for a long time because when I worked in museums, I would write the exhibit labels. I would write, all our manuals and materials for the website. So I've been writing about science and dinosaurs, engineering for a long time.
Whose idea was it to do this particular book?
My idea. So I was actually in Thailand when the boys were trapped in the cave. So during the entire rescue, I was in Thailand. And then when we came back, it was my idea. I called my agent and I said, I know I don't have time to do this, but I have to do this. I really want to write this story. And specifically, I want to center the Thai perspective on the story as much as possible. And so we very quickly put together a proposal and went out with it, and it was a very whirlwind process.
Which can be fun. It's a different process when it's whirlwind and of the moment than when you have time to spin your fantasies, for
That's
instance.
right. Yes. Yeah, there was a lot of interest in the story, as you can imagine, and I just got so lucky to be with Candlewick because they really supported me. They were very encouraging of giving me the time to go back to Thailand to conduct research, to do all of the interviews. That was really important to me. I felt like I had to go back there and meet
Yes.
with local people in person. And this book would not be the book that it is now if I hadn't done that. So, yeah.
That's wonderful. And thank you so much for sharing all of those experiences with lots of readers who will be able to share them now. It's wonderful. So I have one more question that we have time for, I'm hoping. And that is, back in the day, when you were a reader yourself of children's books because you were a child, not because you liked them necessarily, that's what was at hand. Tell us a little bit about what you were reading behind the counter at your parents' restaurant.
All fantasy, all magic stories, A Wrinkle in Time, Matilda, Lion, the Witch in the Wardrobe, Natalie Babbitt. Her books were some of my favorites. Yes, anything that was taking me out of this world into another world.
Wonderful.
Very different from all 13.
Right, in which they left the real world in some really significant ways and
That's
got to come
right.
back.
Yes, still lots of adventure, but very different.
So, what's your next adventure?
I'm working on a graphic novel right now. Yeah.
Fantastic.
I can't say anything about it other than I'm working on it. Yeah, it hasn't been talked about or announced, but
That's
that's
wonderful.
yeah. I'm excited.
Oh, I look
A new adventure, something, it's always something new.
Well, I hope that when it's published, I'll have the opportunity to interview you again so that we can talk about it.
I would love that so much. Okay,
So thank you, Christina. It's been wonderful talking to you this afternoon. And now you better get to that birthday
yes, that's right. I have cake to eat. Thanks.
Bye.